August the 6th of 2011, the lives of 30 American warriors were taken when a Chinook helicopter was shot down by Taliban forces in Afghanistan. 22 on board were among America's elite forces, the Navy SEALs. Was it our own government who put them in harm's way?
Just 90 days before that deadly crash, America was celebrating the successful raid that killed Osama bin Laden. But there was one thing that was decided that night that seemed to be forgotten very quickly.
Frankly, a week ago Sunday in the Situation Room, we all agreed that we would not release any operational details from the effort to take out bin Laden. That all fell apart on Monday, the next day.
The incredible, the phenomenal, the just almost unbelievable capacity of his Navy SEALs and what they did last Sunday.
Today, here at Fort Campbell, I had the privilege of meeting the extraordinary special ops folks who honored that promise. It was a chance for me to say on behalf of all Americans and people around the world, job well done. They're America's quiet professionals. Because success demands secrecy.
While Washington was gloating over their victory, Navy SEAL Aaron Vaughn, who was serving in Afghanistan, was calling home in a panic, warning that word was out that he and his fellow SEALs were in danger, even warning his family they may be targeted as well.
The media has let this man get away with saying, Uncle Joe's gaffes, Uncle Joe's gaffes. This is not Uncle Joe, and he's not some senile old grandfather. He is the second in command of the most powerful country in the world.
And on August 6, 2011, Vaughn's concerns became a reality when he boarded that helicopter that was to be shot down, taking the lives of every soul on board. That single attack marked the deadliest loss ever in the history of U.S. naval special warfare.
That incredibly tragic day for our country leads us to ask, are our politicians' desire for political gain leaving our brave men and women with targets on their backs? Joining me now are Aaron's parents, Billy and Karen Vaughn. Billy is the author of the book, Betrayed, the Shocking True Story of Extortion 17, told by a Navy SEAL's father. Billy, you know, I heard that snippet in the interview, and it seems pretty evident that you feel like that the Obama administration, in many ways, all but put a target on your son's back.
Absolutely. The families of the Navy SEALs never tell who our sons are. If you were to ask Aaron or any of these guys what they did, they'd simply say we're in the military. But our president has gloried in their successes time and time again, and by exposing them, by exposing their names, the name of the unit, and then by also making agreements with the Afghan government, allowing them, the Afghans who operate with the SEALs and operate with our special operations, to not be vetted properly, they have absolutely put a target on their back.
So there's a very good chance that inside information from Afghanistan forces could have tipped off the Taliban as to where that Chinook was going to be and who was on that Chinook.
Absolutely. Yes, sir. Absolutely. I believe that. In fact, the military will not say beyond a shadow of a doubt that it was not an ambush. The best that we were told in the debriefing by General Jeffrey Colt is that we don't believe it was an ambush. But everything that we've seen points to the possibility, the probability of a setup.
But the fact is, your son believed that once the president and the vice president went out there and started spiking the football, that he believed his life was in danger because of that.
Absolutely. Aaron did, and now we found out the rest of the special operations community did, too. We've also seen clips of Secretary of Defense Gates talking at Camp Lejeune to answering other special operators' questions about concerns for them and their families also, Governor.
Karen, I want you to tell me a little bit about Aaron, because, you know, as a mom, I don't want to lose the fact that this is not just a Navy SEAL.
Right.
You know, Aaron was a Navy SEAL. That means a lot to us, and we say, wow, he's the best of the best. I mean, these guys train for the impossible. But he's your son.
You're going to make me cry.
Yeah, you're going to make me cry. So, but, I mean, he's your son, and I want you to remind us of who Aaron is as a person, not just a Navy SEAL.
Thank you for personalizing. Gosh, see, you did. You know, the most important thing that I can tell you, Governor, about Aaron is that he had a personal relationship with Christ. Mm. And because of that, he never doubted, where he would spend eternity should something happen to him while he was working. And he also felt like he was one of the most honored human beings in the world to get to do what he did. He felt like he'd been created to do it. I tell people all the time, Billy and I do, that by the time Aaron was 8 years old, he'd tell anyone who cared to listen that one day he was going to be a Navy SEAL. And he overcame unimaginable odds to do it. And, you know, one thing that we like to say is Aaron lived 90 years and 30. You know, we have, other than, of course, Aaron being taken from us so soon, we have no regrets over the life he chose. We're very proud of him, very honored that he chose to honor his country, his God, his family, his community, and do such amazing things with his life. He was an incredible human being.
Billy, you make it very clear that you didn't really want to write this book, but you said you had to because, and I quote, "We deserve to know the truth. American people deserve answers, and our government, steeped in denial, needs a wake-up call." Are we any closer to the truth today than we were?
Actually, we have a lot of the truth. We know that they were flying in an antiquated helicopter because we don't have enough special operations choppers. We know that in 2009, the coin strategy was adopted in Afghanistan. And from the time that we entered Afghanistan under President Bush up until 2009, we had 1,000 deaths, but we've had over, let me say this correctly.
Well, what it was, in the first 9 years, it took 9 years to have 1,000 U.S. deaths in Afghanistan. In 27 months after this administration took over and we adopted the coin strategy, 27 months later, we'd reached the next 1,000 deaths.
What is
deaths.
The coin strategy?
The coin strategy is the counterinsurgency is what it is. It's winning the hearts and minds of the Afghans, winning the hearts and minds of the enemy. It's
rather than winning wars.
Rather than winning the war. That's absolutely right. And we've been told that we're winning their hearts and minds, but we can tell you without a shadow of a doubt, Aaron never told us when he was training to be a SEAL, "Dad, they're training us to win hearts and minds."
Yeah, that was not what his mission was.
Absolutely not. Absolutely not.
Karen, tell me about the last conversation you had with Aaron.
We were in a hotel room just before Aaron deployed. His little daughter had been born 3 weeks prior, and we'd been there to see him before he deployed, to see her because she'd just been born, and also to be with him for his 30th birthday. He turned 30 just before he left. And the most memorable thing that I remember is just saying, "Son, I guess you'll be safer now than you've ever been since you're actually deploying as a member of SEAL Team 6. And he said, "No, actually, Mom, this will be the most dangerous deployment I've ever been on." And as we look back, we think now there were a lot of warning signs. Aaron hugged me longer and differently than he'd ever hugged me goodbye when we said goodbye that night. I actually turned to walk into the hotel, and I could feel that he hadn't moved, turned around and looked, and he was still just staring at me. And I will hold that the rest of my life is just, he knew it was going to be very dangerous, Governor. And I believe it's because he knew what a target had been put on his team's back. I believe all of them were very concerned about, they're not concerned about their safety. They just knew this was going to be extraordinarily dangerous where they were working and who they were going to be fighting, the Haqqani network, the Pakistani Taliban. It was going to be really bad, and he knew it. And
made worse by the fact that you had a president and a vice president going out and letting the world know these are the folks who did
absolutely.
It. They didn't want that publicity.
Absolutely.
I want to thank you for your story, and it's powerful, and it's painful to hear it because, I realize you've got a son you're never going to get to spend the time with. I don't know that it could have been avoided, but it might could. And I hope you get answers to your questions. And I hope people, as they read your book, will understand that this is not just about the nebulous SEALs. This is about Aaron, who is the son to Billy and Karen. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Governor.
God bless both of you.